So my absolute first memory of macro photography is to return from school, and my grandfather had these amazing books by Nat Geo, and he used to sit and show me these amazing, beautiful pictures of spiders and bugs and beetles and insects with moths. So today I'm out here because I found one of these spiders with some beautiful color on it, and I'm going to be using some basic equipment that I have, and I'll walk you through how to shoot a macro photography shot with a light. So setting this up, and the handle just broke on me. So now you're left with this contraption. Guys, I am using the Godox V860 light, and attached to this is a Octa, small Octa, which I use for portrait shoots or when we're shooting weddings and stuff like that. So this actually does come with a handle to hold, so then you can move it around, or your assistant can keep it pointed at your subject at all given points of time. But since that handle is broken, I have mounted this directly, which I think limits the direction of light. But that's okay, I'm going to try to figure out a way where I can just lay it down. But then actually the sun is coming up today, so might not even need it in the first place.
That is the frog.
Oh, the sunlight's absolutely beautiful. So the sun has finally decided to come out after about 3 days, and without wasting any more time, I am going to start shooting. I will see you guys in a bit. I'm going to do a quick couple of shots of the frog and the stick insect. I might not even need the light at the end of it. So yeah, stay tuned. I'll probably do the whole light thing on another video. So I have a couple of really cool shots. So let me see if I can show you guys these. Sometimes you just strike luck while shooting, and you can't really explain that. I'm gonna go back and do some more shots. When I was shooting the frog, I turned around and I noticed the same stick insect that I saw earlier, and the sun was coming out from behind me and it was backlit, which was absolutely beautiful. I'll show you the shot in a bit. But then when I turned around, I don't know where the frog went. I know he's somewhere in this patch here, but I don't really want to push everything and move everything just to try to find my subject. And oh my god, I'm having so much of fun today in the morning. Finally, I'm here to shoot the spider, and he has spun his web, and the web looks absolutely beautiful. I have a nice bright light come from there, which is the sun right now, and I think the timing is absolutely perfect because it is slightly backlit. There is a lot of thick foliage that's happening over there, so I don't think I'm gonna have to pump up my ISO too high. So I'm gonna could do this shot that I've been waiting to do. Okay, so the most important thing is I don't really want to disturb his webbing, because the webbing by itself looks absolutely gorgeous right now, and I can see him look at me. My settings that I'm running as of now are about 1/400th of a second. I think I'm going to drop it down to 250. I'm going to open up my aperture to about an f4 or an f3.5, and I'm shooting at ISO 320. So I'm going to take one shot first just to see if I like the exposure and if I like the meter. Now right now I think I'm running an evaluative metering. Let's change that to spot. So that'll give me a more accurate idea. Check that out, guys. I'm so excited for that shot right now. It's so beautiful. I'm gonna give it some more time and see if he moves back to the center of the web, and that way I can get a little bit of the webbing as well. Oh, there's another one right behind him. That is going to happen right now when I do switch on the flash, is most of my shots until now were all backlit. So when I sidelighted using the flash that is set up behind me, I'm expecting it to have more light on the subject, but at the same time I don't really know because I haven't experimented too much with this. So let's go take a couple of shots and see what they look like. Okay, so what I can tell you that is going to happen as of now is the moment I do attach the flash and I do sidelight it, what was predominantly a backlit shot is going to change massively in characteristics, and I am almost running out of battery on this. So I'm going to go quickly take a couple of shots, and if you do like this video, do give it a thumbs up. Also, if you do have any comments, please do leave your comments in the comment section.